Do you know that why pneumatic test is required in the plant? Yes, in this video, we are going to discuss about the why pneumatic test is required in the plant. In this video, we are going to discuss about the why pneumatic test is required. What are the precautions while doing the pneumatic test? What is the procedure for the pneumatic test? And in the last, we are going to discuss about the application of the pneumatic test. Okay. Hello, engineers. Welcome in LearnCHE. Before starting the video, if you haven't joined our LearnCHE YouTube channel and our LearnCHE community, you can join it and press the bell icon so that you could get the latest notification. Okay, so let's start the video with why pneumatic test is required. First of all, where we use the pneumatic test? Actually, it is used where hydrostatic test cannot be used. Okay, there is a one test that is a hydrostatic test and there is another test that is a pneumatic test. Okay. Why we use that test? Actually, we use that test to find out that whether there is any leakage or not within our pipeline or within our the loop, within the pipeline or within the loop. Okay. First of all, why we do the test? Because we want to check out the leakage. Okay. In the pipeline or in the loop. Okay. And where we will do the pneumatic test? Where we cannot perform or we cannot do the hydrostatic test. Okay. There are sometimes I have seen that suppose if where we can do the hydrostatic test, but due to less time, we do not do the hydrostatic test and we go with the pneumatic test. Okay. That is also I have seen, but most of the cases where we have to do the hydrostatic test, we will do that, and where we have to do the pneumatic test, we will do pneumatic test where. Okay, it is decided mainly by the application and we will discuss that further. Okay, now pneumatic pipe testing is conducted using air. Air is a medium. Okay, medium of the test. Okay, testing medium to ascertain the structural integrity of the pipeline or the vessel. Means whether your vessel or your pipeline or your loop is okay or not. Okay or not okay means it means that whether there is any leakage or not. Got it my point? That's why we do the pneumatic test. It is mainly carried out to check the leakage from the loop, okay, and mainly in the flange, okay, before startup of the plant or section. Okay, suppose if your plant is shut down and it is going to start up. Okay, so before startup we will do the pneumatic test. Okay, suppose if we like there are different section in your plant or in your, okay, in your plant, let's suppose high pressure section, medium pressure section and vacuum section. Okay, so it will depend that where you have to do the hydrostatic test and where you have to do the pneumatic test. But before startup, we will do that. Got it my point? Before, because this is my loop. Okay, this is one my loop. So we have to check that whether there is any leakage or not from these loop or these vessels, and their condition and their structural integrity is okay or not. Got it my point? That's why we do the pneumatic test. Now let's see the what precautions we take while doing the pneumatic test. Okay, and that is very very important. If you are working in the plant and if you are about to go in the plant, so that is very very important. That is a precautions or safety. Okay, that two term is very very important for any engineers. Okay, so while doing the pneumatic test, okay, it involves the hazard of the released gas energy stored in the compressed gas. Actually, air is a compressed gas. Okay, so it may damage. If there is any leakage, so it may damage the environment, and there may be some hazard gases within that vessel and pipeline. Got it my point? So safety consideration must be there in case of any that uncertainty happen. So you must have the safety consideration, first thing. Second thing, care must be taken in case of leakage happen. Okay, if suppose why we are doing this test, to check the leakage, and suppose if there is any leakage happen, so you must have the proper like checklist, proper SOP, that what you have to do then. Okay, test pressure is very important. Okay, why that is important? Because every section has a different design pressure and operating pressure. Okay, that will have a different design pressure and operating pressure. So it will be like your pneumatic test. You have to do the pneumatic test. So you will like provide air or any other gas at a certain pressure. Okay. So that pressure is very, very important. Okay. With respect to the safety of the pipeline, safety of the loop and safety of the vessels. That's why. Okay. And that test pressure should be decided as per the MOC during design. Okay. What is that test pressure? That test pressure which we will use while pneumatic test, that is very, very important. Okay, first of all, and second thing, when the vendor and when your vessel and your pipeline will be designed, okay, so that MOC, like as per that MOC, that test pressure will be given by the vendor. Okay, and if the vendor do not give you the dead test pressure for the pneumatic test, so as per the MOC, okay, you will decide the test pressure. Okay, so what is the MOC? MOC basically material of construction of the vessel or of the pipeline. Okay, and pressure relief devices must be there. Why that is there? Because you are injecting the air there, okay, to pressurize the loop. So suppose in case there is a overpressurization, so what will happen? It may rupture our pipeline or our vessel. That's why the PRD means pressure relief device must be there. Okay, if suppose there is any like overpressurization, so PSV can be pop up. It will prevent your system and prevent your vessels from the overpressurization. Then set point of the PRD should not be higher than the test pressure. Okay, why? Let's see, if the test pressure is 1 kg, let's suppose, okay, and your PRD and your PSV set point is 2 kg. So it does not make any sense, because we have to perform test, like we have to perform the pneumatic test at 1 kg per centimeter square, right? And your PSV will be pop up at 2 kg per centimeter square, right? So it must be within the range. Okay, that PSV. And in the last, if you are not using air as a testing medium, right, then it should be non-flammable and non-toxic. Means if you are using any other gas, if you are using, then that must be non-flammable and non-toxic. Got it my point? And we also use the other gas as well, like I have seen the nitrogen to use for the pneumatic test. Okay, mainly we use the air, but there are sometimes I have seen the pneumatic test with the nitrogen as well. Okay, and if there is any gas which you have seen for the pneumatic test, please let me in the comments box. Okay, so these are the precautions while performing the pneumatic test that you must know. Okay, now what is the procedure? What is the procedure for the pneumatic test? Okay, let's see here. First of all, place the blinds at the right place and isolate the loop. Okay, what is this means? It means that this is our diagram. Okay, my drawing is not too much good, but this is the diagram and we have to perform the pneumatic test here, and this system is low pressure section. Okay, means low means vacuum section, you can simply say. Okay, so what we will do, first we will provide the blind. Okay, so where we will provide the blind? Okay, so this is our diagram, this is the diagram of the vacuum section. Okay, just I have make that diagram to understand you that how we do the pneumatic test. Okay, where this is my evaporator, this is a separator, EA, that is a condenser, this is ejector. Okay, and I have given the name, then same, that is a evaporator, then that is a separator, condenser, ejector, then same, that these all are the condenser and ejector system. And in the last, this is a our tank. Okay, and this is our the pump. Okay, that will go into the filling tower, because this is a vacuum section of the urea plant. Now see one thing, what is that? So while performing the pneumatic test, we will have to isolate the inlet and outlet of the loop. Okay, so what we will do, we will isolate the loop. So from where we can isolate the loop? From here. Okay, you will have to provide the blind here, because it is about to go into the tank, like V1. From here I'll provide the blind, means we will provide the blind here. It means that, right, like your all condensate is going into the V1, that is a simply our tank, and those gases which are non-condensable, that is again going into the EJ1, and from here the LS is coming. So that is a, one is a driving fluid and another is a motive fluid, and that is again going into the condenser to the further condensation, and in the last it will go into the V1. That is a half diagram of the vacuum section. But why I have taken this diagram, just to know you, just to tell you that how to perform the pneumatic test. Okay, so we have provided the blind here. Now we will also provide the one blind here, right? Just check it out, and this IV will be closed, suction IV will be closed. Okay, now what we will do, first we have provided the blind. Now increase the pressure gradually until the test pressure is reached. Okay, so what you have to do, first you will provide the air. Okay, I am providing air from here, okay, upstream of the ejector, and this is the LS line, and that air line is also connected with the LS line. Okay, so I'll provide air from here, okay, from the upstream of the ejector. Now what will happen, that I'll provide that air, or I'll increase the pressure gradually. Okay, not like sudden I have to provide the pressure. And let's suppose my test pressure is 0.5 kg per centimeter square. Okay, then what you have to do, you have to hold the pressure at each step for the long enough to equalize the piping strain. Okay, why? Because we have to equalize the piping strain, that is very very important with respect to the safety. Got it? And when the test pressure is reached, hold the pressure so that it could know that whether system is okay or not. See here, okay, let's suppose your test pressure is reached. Now what you will do, you will hold, okay, you will hold the dead pressure, then you will check it out that whether, let's suppose you have hold the pressure at 0.5 kg, okay, and after some time you see that your pressure is 0.3 kg or per centimeter square, it means that there may be some leakage. So you will check it out, that leakage, you can find out that leakage, and if you found that leakage, so you can attend it by the mechanical, first things. Okay, second thing, what you can do, there are so many flanges, okay, at the, like suppose there is one flange, then second flange is there, okay, there will be flange which connects the exchanger and pipeline. So you have to check the leakage there with the soap solution and with the any other solution which you use to check out the leakage, okay, if there is any leakage or not. If there is no leakage, then your system is okay for the startup. If there is any leakage, so attend it. Why it is important? Because if you will not attend it, so leakage will be go further, and it may damage the system, and it will also make the problem while doing the startup. Got it, my point? So that's why this is very very important. Okay, that is how we do the pneumatic test. Now what are the applications of the pneumatic test? Okay, now at the last, what are the applications of the pneumatic test? So first application is that it is mainly performed where low pressure application means, like if there is any system or any section, there is a pressure is low means, let's suppose 5 kg per centimeter square. It may be more as well, it depends on the industry to industry, but mainly in a vacuum section, in pre-vacuum section, low pressure section, we may use the pneumatic test. Okay, in the vacuum section and pre-vacuum section, we do the pneumatic test to check out the leakage. Okay, and it is used where hydrostatic test cannot be done. I have already told you that, like, sometimes due to time shortage, we do the pneumatic test rather than hydrostatic test. Okay, but like it shouldn't be do. Okay, if we do not have time, just extend your time, because hydrostatic test application is different as compared to the pneumatic test. Okay, we should not skip the test while before startup, because that is very very important to find out the leakage. Got it, my point? And in our upcoming video, we are going to discuss about the hydrostatic test, that is very very important. Okay, so it was the video about the pneumatic test. I hope you understood that why pneumatic test is performed, what are the applications of the pneumatic test, what are the precautions and procedure of the pneumatic test. Okay, if you have any doubt, लेट मी इन द कमेंट्स बॉक्स, लेट मी इन द कमेंट्स बॉक्स एट विच टॉपिक डू यू वॉन्ट फ्रॉम अस, ओके, सो डैट आई कुड मेक दैट टॉपिक फॉर यू. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर द टूडेज वीडियो. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग. सी यू सून.